New York, June 1700. It is 7 o'clock on a warm summer morning.
A ship is arriving in New York.
Its name is the Red Rose. Two of the people on it are Henry Smith and his daughter Zoe. Henry Smith and Zoe are English, but now they are starting a new life in America. "Look, Dad," says Zoe. "We're here. We're really here." The Henry Smiths say goodbye to all their friends. Then they leave the Red Rose. There are lots of people, horses, and carts beside the ship. Henry Smith looks at them. "Yes, we're here," he thinks. "But now what? We haven't got any money." He stops a young man with a green coat. "Excuse me," he says. "I'm looking for a job." The man turns to his right. "Talk to Jack Crane," he answers. Jack Crane is a farmer. He has a long, thin face and only three fingers on his right hand. He listens to Henry Smith's story. Then he takes off his hat. "Okay," he says, "you can both have jobs. I need a new man to work in the fields. And we want someone to help in the kitchen, too, isn't that right, Blue Sky?" There is an Indian girl on top of the cart. "Yes," she says and smiles at Zoe. 2 hours later, the Henry Smiths leave New York with Jack Crane and Blue Sky. They are both very happy. "How far is it to your farm, Mr. Crane?" asks Henry Smith. 80 kilometers, Jack Crane answers. They drive all afternoon. Zoe is sitting next to Henry Smith. She is tired, but she does not want to sleep. "This is America," she thinks, "and now I'm American." After 6 hours, Jack Crane stops the cart. "Well, there it is," he says. Zoe stands up. It is evening now, and the sun is going down. In front of them, there are lots of beautiful yellow fields and a big farmhouse. Zoe looks to her left. "Where's that smoke coming from?" she asks. "That's the Indian village," answers Blue Sky. "My family lives there." The next day, the Henry Smiths start work. Zoe helps Blue Sky in the farmhouse. First, the two girls cook everyone's breakfast. Then they make all the beds. After that, they clean the kitchen floor. At the Henry Smithy time, Henry Smith is working in the fields. After 4 or 5 hours, he stops for a minute. "What are you stopping for?" asks Jack Crane. "Come on, get back to work." Henry Smith and Zoe have only one free day every week, Sunday. It's Blue Sky's free day, too. That is when she visits her family. One Sunday, Zoe goes with her. She makes a lot of new friends. She meets the village chief, Two Silver Cloud. He has a beautiful wife and a young son. After that first visit, Zoe often goes to the village. She starts to learn some Indian words, too. Zoe is always happy with her new Indian friends. But she is not happy on the farm. Henry Smith is unhappy, too. I don't want to work here on Jack Crane's farm anymore, he says one evening. I want to work on my farm, Henry Smith's farm. I know, Dad, Zoe answers. Then she thinks, but how? We can't buy any land. Jack Crane pays us only $2 a week. 4 days later, Zoe and Blue Sky are making the beds. Suddenly they hear something. Two men are shouting. Zoe looks out of the window. She can see Jack Crane and her father in front of the farmhouse. Jack Crane's face is very red. Do it, he shouts. No, I'm not going to, Henry Smith shouts back. It's Sunday and I don't work on Sundays. You do it. Zoe runs downstairs and out of the house. There is a strong wind and it is raining. What's happening? She asks her father. We're leaving in the morning, Henry Smith answers. He is walking very fast. Zoe looks at him. But how are we going to eat? We haven't got any money. Henry Smith does not answer. His eyes are cold and hard. That evening, Zoe and Blue Sky go to the Indian village. This is going to be my last visit. Zoe thinks. Blue Sky is sad, too. She does not want to lose her friend. The two girls say nothing for 20 minutes. Then Blue Sky stops her horse. She can see something in the river to their right. It is a small boy. Help, he is shouting. I can't swim. Help me. Please. It's the chief's son, says Blue Sky. What are we going to? But before she can say another word, Zoe gets off her horse. I'm coming, she shouts. Then she jumps into the cold river. Help! Shouts the boy. Zoe swims to him. His head is going under the water. She puts one arm around him. It's okay, she says. You're safe now. Half an hour later, Zoe and Blue Sky arrive at the Indian village. The chief comes to meet them. But I don't understand, he says to Blue Sky. Why is my son with you? And why are he and the English girl wet? Blue Sky tells him the story. After that, the chief is very happy. He smiles at Zoe. How can I thank you? He says. Please. Let me give you something. Anything. At 9 o'clock, Henry Smith is putting some boots into a bag. What's going to happen tomorrow? He thinks. Suddenly, the door opens. It is Zoe. Come with me, Dad, she says. I want to show you something. Henry Smith looks at his daughter. Her eyes are bright and she is smiling. What are you talking about? He asks. There isn't time for any questions, says Zoe. Come on. She takes her father to a hill. At the top she says, look. Can you see that land over there? Yes, Henry Smith answers. Then Zoe tells him about Silver Cloud's son. After she finishes, Henry Smith says, "You mean?" Yes, Zoe smiles at her father. The Indians are giving us our own farm. Henry Smith's farm. Oh, Dad, isn't it wonderful? Now we can really start a new life. Level 1, Beginner. Basic Vocabulary. About 300 basic words. Congratulations on your dedication and good luck. Text read in American English. Level 1, Beginner. End of text by Easy English Abreu.